Hello, it's Keaton here today, and I am going to show you about jUnit. jUnit is the way you write unit tests in Java, and unit tests help you create code that does what you expect it to do, and also it helps you keep from breaking your code when changes need to be made. So to start our example, we have a pretty simple triangle class. It's just made up of three sides and has a toString that will print it out for us. So we can run it quickly in an application. Here we've made a new triangle with sides 4, 5, and 3, and then we're going to print out the triangle. You can see here it just has side 4, 5, and 3. So what if we made, this side 50? Print it out, and we get a triangle with sides 4, 50, and 3. But that, of course, wouldn't work. There's no way that a triangle with side 50 could have two other sides that were 4 and 3. They just never connect. So we ought to make our code handle that. I'll do that by testing for valid sides here in the constructor. I'll put down the name of a method that I haven't written yet, but I know that I want it to take all three sides, and it will tell me if the sides are valid or not. So I can put it in a block here, and if it fails that test, then I can throw a new illegal argument exception. And we can put a little message here about what went wrong. So now I have my test and my exception. I need to actually make the method that will run the test, and I can use Eclipse to get me started. And it gave me this method stub here. It has all my sides as doubles, and it returns a boolean, but I'm gonna make it public and static so that maybe I can test my sides before I try to construct things. So now I have to figure out what I'm going to do, and the sides can make a triangle if the sum of two sides is greater than the third. So we can write a test that look for that. Here I will say if the sum of my two side parameters is less than or equal to the third, then I'll return false. And if it passes that test, then I'll return true. We now have a method that will test for valid sides of a triangle, so now it seems like a good time to make a unit test so we can really check this piece of code and make sure it does what we expect. So the first thing we need to do is make a place to put the unit test file. And I like to make a new folder and give it a name that helps us keep track of it. And it's a good idea to say it's a test right in the name so we remember. And I do it this way just to keep the tests separate, because sometimes there's a lot of tests and it's easy to mix them up with your regular code. And I'll give the package the same name as my code, or the package that contains my code. I can do this because it's in a different folder. In case it was JUnit video. And now I can create my unit test. An easy way to do this is just go right click and go into this menu and find the JUnit test case. Now we can give it a name. It's going to test my triangle class. I'll call it the triangle test. And can't pick the class that it's going to test. And it sets up a class stub for you to start with. Before we start writing our test, I want to point out the test annotation. That's really important to have before a test method because it will make the method run as a test. If it's not there, then Eclipse doesn't think it's a test. So when you go to write your own, you got to make sure you have it. Now we got to name our test method, and it's important to give it a really descriptive name. Here we're testing the isTriangle method, so we can put that right in the name. And you want to give it descriptive names because then when you go to run your test, it's really easy to tell what has passed and what has failed. So now we can use some of the assert methods, which Eclipse imported for us with this static jUnit assert when we created this jUnit test file. And we'll use an assert true, and this will just, it's whatever we put in here should be true, and that will determine if the test passed or fail. So we use our static triangle method, call it on the class, and give it a valid triangle, which 3, 4, 5 should work. That should be valid. Let's run this test and we can see if it'll pass. So this big green bar here means all our tests pass, and we can open it up and see which tests ran. And we can see here the test of isTriangle ran and passed. Now let's think about what other tests we could write. So we go look at our triangle class and we see we tested when this isTriangle method is true and that passed. So we could test when it's false, and we see when the isTriangle is false, we try to construct an invalid triangle that we get an illegal argument exception. And it's always a good idea to test for the exceptions you throw, so let's go write a test for that. I'll just copy and paste what I have here, and you use the test annotation, the same test annotation as we did before, except you add a few extra things. This expected equals a legal argument exception, and that's just the exception you're testing for, which here it was obviously an illegal argument exception. So what this says is when this method runs, it will pass if the code in it throws an illegal argument exception. So I made a new triangle and gave it sides, one side that was just way too big. These other sides will never add up to be greater than that side, so this should be an invalid triangle and should throw this illegal argument exception. I'll run the test now and we can see what we get. So I run the test and this big red bar means we had a failure. I look down here and it was the test of invalid triangle that failed. So we look here and we obviously tested for an illegal argument exception. Go back to our triangle class and we see we created an invalid triangle, so this method, if it failed, it should have thrown a legal argument exception. But it obviously didn't. So the problem must be in our isTriangle method. So then I come down here and I can see that I tested for one possible combination of sides, but not the others. So I should do that. So we'll do, we did A plus B is less than C, so we'll do the others. I do A plus B, or A plus C is less than B. And B plus C is less than A. Save that and run the test again. And now all the tests pass. So one thing I did notice now, we're testing the isTriangle method, but we never tested for any bad triangles. And we should. So I'll use the assert false method and copy and paste a few tests of the isTriangle method with sides that are invalid. And now we can see if that passes too. And it does.